the goals of your group. Remember, we don't separate the vision and the example. They are always together. I cannot separate these functions of a leader. The leader is an innovator. In business today, if you don't innovate, you're dead. Take a look at some of the good businesses before. Well, some of them are dead now. Why? No innovation. They don't adapt to changes, etc. Okay? Do you want to be dead as a catechist? Do you want to be dead as a catechetical organization? Mind you, this is true. If you don't innovate, eh, kaya nga dahil dyan yung Evangelii Gaudium yung Pope, di ba? You cannot remain in the box. Sinasabi niya, you have to get out. Because there are so many changes taking place in people. And that's the challenge to a leader. How to cope with change and how to be true to your mission by starting with some changes. And change implies innovation. Why? As a leader, you always try to seek for improvement. Correct me if I'm wrong. Tama ba ito? Improvement starts with a capital I. Because we seek not only for what is good, we want to do what is better and even achieve what is best, that challenges a leader for improvement. And because a leader seeks improvement, he will always use his imagination to do that, or her imagination. This is what they mean when they say, you have to think outside the box. Bakit parating yung solution na yun ang gagawin mo? Eh, sinauna pa yan. Hindi na epektibo sa akin. Why do you insist? This was being done so many years ago. You have to ask yourself, is this relevant up to now? If not, you better use your imagination, what could be done better or even best. Because a leader uses his or her imagination. He or she is ready to take risks. That's a good leader. Because you want to try out. If this is really giving the best result or a better result. But to remain complacent, that's really the enemy, number one enemy of leadership when you begin having complacency in your life. Yung contento ka na ba? Okay lang yan. Ox na yan. You will never have improvement. Because a leader uses imagination, he will try to solve problems and think about change. Because you're a thinking leader. The fourth There are lots, no, but I only focus on four because to add more, we may lose concentration and focus. So it's better to have a few. Then you stuck with this few. And then when you go home, you have opportunities to read other books, authors on leadership, and that really inspires you to read more. So patikin lang sa sessions natin. Because I cannot really, in one day, that's unimaginable and unachievable. In one day, matatapos kayo, lalabas na kayo na leader. I don't think so. Maging makatotohanan lang tayo. So I'm satisfied by saying, ma-inspire po lang kayo to strive for leadership. To me, that's good enough. That's a goal for today. Maging realistic tayo. Okay, so I'm giving you avenues where possibly you can rethink, you can inspire yourself, areas where you can be leaders and improve yourself as a leader. So a leader is a team builder, not a team destroyer. Again, take a look at the geese. What is that? Diba? Chichichina, go, go, go! Kaya ako lang iway nila. And when the other, the leader is tired, he or she is realistic enough to say, hey, better for you to take over. This is a leader. Okay? And he or she does the other part of support also to the next leader. Hindi yung napalitan ka lang, masama ka pa ito. Tampok ka pa, hindi malarapat pa. Why are you laughing? Kasi you're disturbed. Okay. These are the realities you have to face. Okay. When you go back, you have to face this reality. And you have to think, how will you face them now that you're empowered? With these new ideas in your mind, think and rethink how you can handle the different people in your organization and how you can do your part. So, leadership does not mean doing everything. Okay? Right. The leader involves others. Pwede naman gawin ng iba yun sa tulong mo, sa inspiration mo. Yung pagawa mo sa kanila, bakit mo susuluhin naman? Diba? So that's leadership involving others to fulfill and attain the goal of the organization. It is developing partnership. Partnership! Hindi yung po yan. And of course, teamwork. Here, the science of organizational management can help. So if you have chances to read books on organizational management, even to take courses, don't be afraid because these things can help you. Okay? There are lots of steps that can help you build teamwork through organizational management. So, if you have the chance, go, take that course. Finally, a team leader, a team builder, a leader knows how to delegate. They display enthusiasm. Sinasabi natin, energy, yung force, they display passion, and inspiration to get others attain the high levels of performance. Enthusiasm. Mukhang mga, wala. tingle finger. Wala ka na try, ano ba yan? Tama, kailangan talaga. You have to be enthusiastic. Oh, mauuna sa iyo. Hindi yung sa iyo palang makikita. Headball na. Wala na tayo.
Enthusiastic.
Okay? Second, yung impassion, makikita talaga ito. There's the drive within you to go. Pursue the dream of your organization. Kaya yan, let's go, come on. And inspire them. And get others, get them involved. Attain high levels of performance. A team builder have the ability to inspire confidence and support. They encourage the heart and celebrate the accomplishments of their members. So you shouldn't be afraid with your members. They're doing fine. They're doing better even without you. Okay, you should even encourage them and not be bothered by your power struggle problem. This is a leader. And if you have trained a better leader and he or she takes that position, thanks be to God, there is a new leader who can lead better the group. Kaya niyo?
Yes.
I hope so. Because there are some people who cannot go away with power.
Yes.
Okay? That's why your spirituality cannot be separated in your leadership. Okay? So let me end by saying, leadership requires love. The best leaders are servants. You lead by interacting, giving to others. This is the real measure of leadership. Parang sinabi, no? The measure of loving God is to love God.
Love measure of God. St. Francis.
Love.
St. Francis of Assisi.
Okay. I will be giving you, in the close kanina, okay na. So, I'll be giving you the last part this morning, eh? The last paper. And you cannot finish this before our next section. So, take home assignment ito. In the sense that you don't do it, too bad for you. Diba? You want to grow as a leader, this is an activity that might help you